Chapter 11. Then the Lord said to Moses, "One last plague I will bring upon Pharaoh in Egypt. After that he will let you go. He will send you packing as a man dismisses a rejected bride. Let the people be told that men and women alike should ask their neighbours for jewellery of silver and gold." The Lord made the Egyptians well disposed towards them. And moreover, Moses was a very great man in Egypt in the eyes of Pharaoh's courtiers and of the people. Moses then said, "These are the words of the Lord. At midnight I will go out among the Egyptians. Every firstborn creature in the land of Egypt shall die. The firstborn of Pharaoh who sits on his throne, the firstborn of a slave girl at the handmill, and all the firstborn of the cattle. All Egypt will send up a great cry of anguish, a cry the like of which has never been heard before, nor ever will be again. But among all Israel, not a dog's tongue shall be so much as scratched, no man or beast be hurt. Then you shall know that the Lord does make a distinction between Egypt and Israel. Then all these courtiers of yours will come down to me, prostrate themselves and cry, 'Go away, you and all the people who follow at your heels.' After that, I will go away." Then Moses left Pharaoh's presence, hot with anger. The Lord said to Moses, "Pharaoh will not listen to you. I will therefore show still more portents in the land of Egypt." All these portents had Moses and Aaron shown in the presence of Pharaoh, and yet the Lord made him obstinate, and he did not let the Israelites leave the country.